Little fluff there. What we'll do is we just cut it. It's probably the most time consuming bit, but if you want a good end result, preparation. About the same size. About the same colour. We're using 3769 number sixes. Like I said before, you can use number eights, fours, twos, tens, and twelves. We're using short shank, average size shank, number six. Red body. The rivers here at the moment where I am are low and clear. Get full of weed. Trout are really spooky. So giving a bit of a break, tie a few flies. These can, you can vary the colour of the body on these. You can have green, yellow. I seem to prefer red. Red bodied Mr. Simpson. I've had the best results with these red bodied Mr. Simpsons when just before spawning. Going to use a squirrel tail for the tail. A clump, I would use a clump about two mil diameter, 1/16 of an inch. For those old imperial people, I actually was sort of brought up in the era of 50-50, half imperial and half metric. So when I talk in weights, I talk in pounds, particularly fish weights. And when I talking measurements, I'm sort of talking centimeters. The trade-off is in sort of encouraged me to start talking metric. I like tying this fly, this lure. It's an attractive, a very attractive one, in my opinion. All lined up. So we want the tail to be about the length of the shank, hook shank.
pretty close. And I don't think the fish are going to sort of get a measuring stick out and have a look. Wow, there's always a first time, I suppose. I've never varied the colour of the tail. I've always just used black. I suppose you could vary the colour if you really wanted to. Doesn't matter about what this looks like. It's going to be all covered. We probably don't want black, but sticking right through everywhere. Don't care if we don't cut the mono. I'm using 6 baro mono here. Black, but you could use red to match the body. I'm not quite sure what this body material is called. It's just some samples I've had imported to try it out. I seem to have had good results with it, so it's like a chenille, but it's sparkly. So take the thread back to the bend of the hook. Tie it in when it will tie in. Come on. There we go. Like I say, you know, just near enough, sort of good enough here. I know it's not the attitude, but it's going to be all covered, so. Take the thread out of our way. I've learnt to do half hitches. And then go to my daughter's iPod. Annoying that. Because we're only using 2 pairs of feathers, we're going to take this to about halfway point. Normally with a longer shank you use 3 pairs. Alright, we'll just snitch it off here. We might take a couple more. There we are. A tangle there. There we go. One more time. Alright. Try and use a smaller pier. Put it on the side and a couple of light loops. Beauty of these bodkins is they're retractable, so the thread gets sucked back into them. There you go there, just pull it through a little bit, slide it up round onto the top, back round. Let's have a look. Yeah, I'm quite happy with that. And we'll get the other one. Yeah, put it on this side, just hold it down lightly. A couple more light ones around there. You need to do them light so you can maneuver these feathers. Pull it around onto the top and on. Oh, let's just have a look. It doesn't look too bad. I'm quite happy with that. So straighten those, just pull it around a bit like that. Whoop. Come on. Tighten it down. 1, 2. We'll snip it off. Got the tighter ones now for luck, and half hitch. over to the post, and let's see how we want to try and cover that black mono. I know it's only just cosmetically for me, but there you go. The beauty of this vise is you can rotate it and you can watch as you go. Nice and sparkly, this stuff, isn't it? Come back, tie it off. One, two. And now we'll just slip it off. Come back. You want to come back onto the body. So it's the right thickness, because sort of trial and error. And this one here, we want to come more to the top. A couple of good tight ones. Let's have a look. Beautiful, isn't it? Man. Champion. And layer the other one on the other side about the same place, just a couple of light turns, and pull that up and turn it as you go. Let's have a look at that. I'm happy with that. When they get into the water and they get a bit wet, they'll go right. Let's just tie that off. Oh, I don't want to go too far back. Snip. Snip. We'll do this by hand just so we can get those bits covered. Pitch. And five whips. One, two, three, four, five. Snip, and over on the post. We'll just glue the head. I use wax thread, pre-wax thread, and I'm pretty sure they wouldn't come undone. But the trout have very sharp teeth.